Have you always wanted to be a firefighter? Learn what it takes to get hired.
We'll discuss the education and experience you need to become a Franklin firefighter, including emergency medical requirements.
You'll also learn more about the firefighter candidate testing process.
All this and more on this episode of Franklin Heat.
Welcome to Franklin Heat, the show that takes you behind the scenes and introduces you to some of the members of the Franklin Fire Department. I'm firefighter Jeff Boggs.
And I'm engineer Wylie Jones.
Engineer. Since our last episode, Wylie's been promoted. So while I may know what an engineer does, why don't you tell some of the folks out there who may not know a little bit about what an engineer does?
Well, we've all seen them. No matter what city that you're in, you're driving down the road and you see a fire truck once in a while, red lights and all that. Mm-hmm. The driver of the truck, that's the engineer.
Gotcha.
He's responsible for getting water to the firefighters that are inside and putting the big ladders up on the roof, that kind of thing.
Very cool. Well, I'm glad we are talking about that process because today we're going to talk a little bit about what seems to be the most popular search on the fire department website is the careers. So we're going to give you a little bit of insight as to what it takes to be a well-rounded firefighter candidate.
Then we're going to catch up with Captain Jonathan Jenkins. He's going to be out of the training center, okay. Franklin Fire Department.
Sure.
And he's going to talk to us a little bit about the agility test.
Okay. And then in the studio today, we have the pleasure of introducing Deputy Chief Mike Culberson and EMS Officer Sarah Glenn.
But right now, let's introduce the Chief. Chief, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Welcome, Chief.
Thank you.
Good to see you. Chief, as you're aware, it's actually out of a lot of respect, since years ago, since you started, it has become harder, a lot more challenging to become a firefighter these days, anywhere in the fire service. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit, anyone that's interested in being a firefighter out there especially, what they should expect, the directions they need to go with education and training, that kind of thing?
You hit on a vast array of subject matter there that will attempt to dissect. Back in the early 80s, throughout the 80s, fire departments were predominantly fire back then. Now the trend has changed. About 73-75% of our total call volume yearly is medically generated. Now when we say that, medical calls, anything from cuts and bruises to full-fledged, you know, heart attacks, strokes, things of that nature. So what the city adopted, you basically have to have an emergency medical technician license, whether it be basic or advanced level. To be a firefighter here, you've got to have that license prior to application. You can't be in the process of getting it. Another thing is always helpful is a strong educational background, whether it be an associate's, bachelor's, or master's degree. Another thing is fire experience. Of course, with the economy the way it is, even private companies are looking at candidates. The less they have to invest in that candidate, the best, you know, better off they are.
Sure.
Always, you know, a clean background, no criminal activity.
Yep.
A clean driving record helps. You know, with the trend the way it is with automobile insurance, the city of Franklin is no different. You know, if you have a terrible driving background, then it may be hard to insure you. 21 years of age, a good positive attitude reflects a lot.
Mm-hmm. So our process for firefighter candidates, what would that include as far as the interview process?
As far as the interview process? Mm-hmm. The interview board here in Franklin is made up of pretty much one person out of each rank. There's a bit of a process you have to go through prior to that. There is a general knowledge written test. There is an agility test. once you make it to the oral interview. Then our human resources department takes all of that data and compiles it and comes up with what we call an eligibility list.
What exactly does a deputy chief do?
The deputy chief here in Franklin is predominantly over operations, which covers all of suppression, all of EMS, all of training, and that's a full-time job. He is actually second in command of the fire department and is pretty much over the day-to-day operations.
That's great information. Thanks a lot, Chief. We appreciate it.
We're going to take a short break. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Battalion Chief Greg Baltimore. After evaluation, an applicant may be selected to proceed to the next step of the hiring process, which is a written exam. This multiple choice test is from a leading public human resources organization. It examines a candidate's critical knowledge, skills, ability, and personal characteristics. The test is developed by highly skilled professionals and is extensively validated. A traditional test consists of 90 multiple choice questions, and you are given 2 hours to complete it. You must get 63 answers correct in order to pass. Entry-level firefighter candidates study guides are available at this website. We appreciate your interest in the Franklin Fire Department.
Hi, welcome back to Franklin Heat. Our next guest is EMS Officer Sarah Glenn. Sarah, thanks for coming by today.
Thanks for having me, guys. Sarah.
Now, Chief Culberson mentioned that 70% of our call volume is medically related. So when someone's applying for the fire department, getting an EMT or higher is preferred. Can you elaborate on that a little bit?
Sure, Jeff. A minimum requirement to be hired or to even apply for a job at Franklin is to have an EMT license. Additional points are given for paramedics as well. So to even further that education will give somebody an edge on getting hired. One way that they can obtain that education is at any local community college, they can go through the EMT or paramedic program. You do have to be an EMT before you can apply for paramedic. A lot of people start out at the first responder level, and that's one level below EMT. They can obtain that training through local volunteer fire departments and things like that. And then they can volunteer at that fire department and get some of that fire and EMS experience before they get into the field.
Explain to us a little bit, you mentioned BLS, ALS, to those that don't know, what exactly can you elaborate on those?
Well, here at Franklin, we're an ALS service, which is advanced life support, meaning that our paramedics provide a higher level of care to the citizens that we respond to. So they can provide any care that's given in the back of the ambulance, but we just don't transport the patient to the hospital. So that care is brought to the patient there on the scene, and that care is provided to them by our personnel here on the fire department. A lot of people ask sometimes, why do I see a fire truck pull up when I call 911 for a medical emergency? And that's the reason for that, because we have EMTs and paramedics on fire trucks that are providing that care.
If someone wanted to be a paramedic, all right, and they're just starting out, they have no fire experience, they have no training at all, brand new, what kind of timeline are we looking at starting in that career to possibly riding an ambulance or on a fire truck there? What kind of, are we looking at a year? Are we looking at a year and a half starting at EMT basic, I assume?
Well, they don't have to be a first responder to become an EMT. So they can go directly to EMT school, and that's through any of your local community colleges that they can apply and go through that program. That program's one semester in length. Columbia State even offers an accelerated summer EMT program that's about 10 weeks in length. So people can obtain that licensure in about 10 weeks' time. One thing that I used to recommend for students who were interested in getting into the career fire service when I was the director of the program was that I recommended that they go through the Fire Academy in Bellbuckle and get their recruit firefighter training so that they could get their Firefighter 1 certification and then go to EMT school. They can't be working while they go through the Firefighter 1 program, so it's a little bit easier for people to go through that first, then go into EMT school, because people get offered jobs pretty quickly straight out of EMT school, and it's kind of hard once they get that money coming in to turn that down and go on for the firefighter certifications.
Mm-hmm. So getting some volunteer experience, a Firefighter 1 certification, and at least an EMT would put you ahead of a lot of the other candidates may be in that firefighter candidate service.
Absolutely. That will set you up to be a well-rounded candidate when you apply for a career fire service position at any department, but especially ours. And then also, if they advance on to paramedic, that gives them some additional points and a little bit more of a leg up.
Okay. Thanks, Sarah, for all that information. Thanks for coming by.
Thank you. Thank you guys for having me.
We're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back.
I always wanted to own my own business, but what I needed were the skills to develop a great plan.
In second grade, I made a volcano. Today, I'm seeing the world, one cell at a time.
I want to help. I'm learning what to do when every second counts.
It's not just about the camera. It's all about what's going on behind the scenes.
I discovered the past, and it made the best of my future.
I can see the best of me.
See the best in you. See you here.
Welcome back to Franklin Heat.
Now, Deputy Chief Mike Culberson mentioned a physical ability test that these candidates must go through. Right now, we're going to go to Training Captain Jonathan Jenkins. He's going to tell us a little bit more about that.
Thanks, guys. Once a candidate has passed the written exam, the next step in the process is the physical ability test. In this process, there will be 11 tasks that the candidate must pass in under 7 minutes. The first task is the hose drag. Drag a 50-foot section of 3-inch hose 75 feet. The second task is the hose carry. Carry a 50-foot section of 2.5-inch folded hose approximately 90 feet along the marked route, and then up the stairs to a platform at the top. While you're still upstairs, proceed to the next task, which is the hose pull. Grasp a rope that is attached to a 50-foot length 2.5-inch hose and use it to pull the hose until it reaches the bar at the window. When the hose coupling reaches the window, a monitor will indicate that you have completed task 3. A 100-second timer will now be activated. The fourth task is the 100-second walk. Descend the stairs and follow the marked route to the 4.5-foot wall. If you arrived at the wall before 100 seconds have elapsed, you will have to wait to begin the next task until the 100 seconds expire. The fifth task is scaling a 4.5-foot wall. Next is the ladder raise, where you will raise a 20-foot ladder from the ground to a vertical position. The seventh task, you will climb the ladder about 10 feet onto the platform, then descend the ladder to the ground. Next, you will climb and descend one flight of stairs carrying a 15-pound weight. The ninth task is a forcible entry simulation, where you will hit a 66-pound tire with an 8-pound maul across a 12.5-foot-long metal table. Hit the tire until you have moved it from one end of the table to the other. The 10th task is the tunnel crawl. Crawl through a U-shaped tunnel that is approximately 30 feet long, 32 inches high, 32 inches wide. The final task is the rescue mannequin drag. Drag a 180-pound mannequin 45 feet. After dragging the mannequin across the finish line, the physical test is over. The examiner will record your time. I hope this gives you an understanding of our physical ability test. If you have any questions, please refer to our website or give us a call. Back to you guys.
Thanks for the information, Captain Jenkins.
Well, that wraps it up for us on this episode of Franklin Heat. Now remember, you can go to the Franklin website, franklintn.gov/fire, follow our Twitter feed, and join our YouTube channel for the City of Franklin. Thanks a lot, and we'll see you next time.